north of downtown L.A., we're live from beautiful Dodger Stadium. Today, a contest from the NL West Division between the Arizona Diamondbacks and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Major League Baseball on the show is next. Tony Gonsolin, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that added a new pitch to his repertoire, the split finger. He won't throw it that often. I think one of the reasons he tried to pick up this pitch had a difficult time throwing the straight changeup, and sometimes the splitter is the quick pitch fix for that. So it'll be interesting to see how and when he uses the splitter in this one here today.
And now in the box, Josh Rojas. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. Fastball, close, but he didn't get it, 2-1. And a great day for baseball here. 81 degrees at first pitch. The 2-1. Lifted down the line and left. Pollock has a read on it. Makes the play, one away.
Batting second, the center fielder, Haven Smith.
So one out and nobody aboard. And up next is Paven Smith. One out, nobody on. And he fouls this one off. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. In comes Bellinger. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away.
Third.
Here now is Asdrubal Cabrera. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Now the 2-1. Two balls and two strikes now. Just underway here in Southern California. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Wow, talk about a waste pitch on 2-2. That one wasn't even close. I don't know anyone that would have swung at that pitch.
Pollock able to track it down for the third out. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. And now the Dodgers get a crack at it. No score. Merrill Kelly is on the mound for the Diamondbacks. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a five-pitch repertoire that he has? That gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties. And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
So stepping in is Mookie Betts. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And a big swing and a miss here, two strikes.
The offensive game plan today is certainly to see the ball up. This guy is known on the mound for sinker-changeup combination. He's going to try and establish down in the zone to get swing and a miss or ground balls consistently. You have to find something above the belt to get loose on.
So he sets him down swinging. Mookie Betts is sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning. To the plate now, Justin Turner. 2-1.
Two pitch mix here. If you're in the batter's box, you're looking for something up. Sinker change up right here. Got to get it up.
Now a swing and he pops it foul behind the plate. And he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out.
Batting third. The center fielder.
Time now to check out how the hometown Dodgers line up in this one. Mark DeRosa, tell us about this lineup in a daytime home contest.
Matty, I know this team can swing the bat, but one thing I'm focused on, and I think a huge key for this team, is base running. And I'm not necessarily saying stolen bases, just being aggressive on the base pass. putting a defense on their heels, taking the extra base, maybe that send from first to home. That's what I'm hoping to see. Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Swung on, and this ball is absolutely crushed. Forget about it. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. It's a solo homer for Cody Bellinger, and the Dodgers strike first, 1-0. I'm sure you know what's coming after that bomb. That's right. Let's check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, we see it was projected at over 450 feet. An incredible home run to watch. Into the box, Will Smith. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Two and two to the Dodgers catcher.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Here's another one that's drilled, this one to left. And what an effort on the running play to end the inning. But the Dodgers are on the board first thanks to this solo home run. We'll head to the top of the second, and LA's off to an early 1-0 lead. Second inning set to go, and set to go is the second baseman, Eduardo Escobar. The 1-1 home to 1-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
So now to the plate, David Peralta. A swing and a high drive to right center field. Back goes Betts to the track. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. So a beautiful running catch on display that time as we get a look at it again with ShowTrack. He took a solid route, covered quite a bit of ground, 110 feet to be exact, to bring that one in. That's a catch to remember. Standing in now, Christian Walker. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Dodgers have the early 1-0 advantage as we play the second. Fouled off. Fouled away. The next 3-2. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Diamondbacks down in order. They still trail 1-0. Ready now is Max Muncy. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Now the 1-1 pitch. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
really good pitch right there. So you're moving the ball all around the strike zone. And then what do?
Baseman.
You come in.
Fritz.
That's a hard pitch for any hitter to do anything with. Just really makes it difficult to get that bat head out.
Stepping in now, Chris Taylor. Popped him up. Varsho has a play. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And up next will be Gavin Lux. Bases are empty here with two men out. Pulled toward right center field. Rojas makes the catch. The inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. We play two innings. It's 1-0. The batter will be Dalton Varsho. 7-8-9, bottom of the order set to go here in the third. Hit out towards second. Glove by Taylor. Throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first out. One gun in the Arizona third, and that means that Nick Ahmed will be the next to bat. Diamondbacks still searching for that first hit of the ball game. And tried to get that one airborne, but it's 1-2.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Here now the 2-2. Is laid off and the count runs full.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
So now the pitcher, Merrill Kelly. This is a textbook sacrifice situation, so let's see if that's the call. And he pops up the bunt attempt. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice.
The right fielder, number 10.
Into the box, Josh Rojas. A base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. There's a ball ripped toward the gap in left center. As he arrives at second without a play, as a run comes across to score on the play, tying the ball game.
The pitcher was spotting his pitches effectively until now, working the edges, painting the corners, but he left this one right over the plate, and it cost him with an RBI extra base hit right there.
At the plate, Haven Smith. Ground ball right side. A dive, and he knocks it down. And no chance at a recovery here, as despite a great effort that time, they won't get an out on the play.
The third baseman, Arturo Cabrera.
Into the box now, as Drubal Cabrera. I'll straighten him up there on that fastball. It's 1-2 now. And it's fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And a good pitch there, but it's taken for a ball, and it's 2-2 to the Arizona third baseman.
It looked like he tried to get him to chase on that pitch there, 1-2. A good idea, but I think now he has to challenge him a little bit. He doesn't want to get into a worse situation with the cleanup guy up next.
2-2. Here it is. He struck him out. In and out of trouble as the inning is over. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. Bottom of the third coming up. All even at one apiece. bottom of the third now. And up next, the center fielder, A.J. Pollock. Set to deal on 2-2. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
Well, at the plate, he kind of got bailed out on that previous pitch. I think it should have been a strike. Then he goes down looking, and you really can't feel too sorry for him. Not a lot of protecting with two strikes there.
At the plate now, Tony Gonsolin. Dodgers pitcher trying to deal with a 1-2 count at the plate. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
So a full count now.
There's the heavy sinker right there. What makes that pitch so difficult to hit is not only does it change eye levels, it actually changes plane. You go to hit it at one position and it's 6 to 8 inches dropping off the table and chasing your hands.
The next 3-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Rojas is there and he'll bring this one in. Here's Mookie Betts. He went down swinging to start the home first. Two out, nobody on. Two and one now to Mookie.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
Now the 2-1. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. The 2-2. And this pitch is taken here for ball four. So the Dodgers able to extend the inning here with two away.
Now batting, third baseman, Justin.
Next to stand in is Justin Turner, 0 for 1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through. Runner aboard at first here with two gone in a 1-1 ball game. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike.
Hey, that's a great job by the pitcher right there, stealing a strike with that get me over breaking ball. And now he can get a little nastier with it in the dirt.
And that one misses badly. It's ball two. To first. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. One left for L.A. Through three complete, all tied one apiece. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Torey Lovello about the Diamondbacks' offensive production. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. All set for the start of the inning, and standing in is the power-hitting second baseman, Eduardo Escobar. And there's ball two now. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Lifted down the line and left. On the move is Pollock, but he won't get to it, and this should put a man in scoring position to start the inning. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Up next for the Diamondbacks, the left fielder, David Peralta.
Into the box, David Peralta. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Man, I'm interested to see this next pitch. Three balls pounded on the inside half of the plate. He either has no respect for this hitter or he's setting him up to go down and away.
And he fouls this one off. Ripped down the line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
In now, Christian Walker. And he rolls over this one foul. We'll do it once more. 3-2.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
And another foul ball. Has a look, now the pitch. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
And with first base open, the last thing he wanted to do was give him something to hit in the heart of the zone. So no harm done. Force out anywhere now.
Next, it'll be Dalton Varsho. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
2-1 the count. From the belt, the pitch.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
The 2-2 will not catch the zone. Ball three.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Three-two pitch. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
And things are not looking good here in the fourth inning. That's the second walk of the frame. Good time for the catcher to go out to the mound and have a chat with this guy to give him a little breather.
Stepping in once again is Nick Ahmed. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. Here's a fly ball, well hit. Gone! It's a grand slam. So one swing, and he unloads the bases on that one, and it's suddenly a 5-1 ball game.
Hey, you drive to the park and dream of coming through with a big knock with runners in scoring position. Bases loaded in that situation. Didn't try and do too much. They always tell yourself, calm yourself down and just get that guy in from third. He got them all in, Dan.
You know, D-Row, this is what makes it so tough to be a pitcher, right? You have them loaded, no place to put anybody. You make one bad pitch, and in one swing, four runs on the board. A huge swing in this one.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
So now to the plate, Josh Rojas. Ball four.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
David Price answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. Haven Smith will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. Four runs here in this half inning. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Boy, he just threw that fastball by him. Here now the 2-2. Pretty well hit deep down the line in right, but that's back into the seats foul. Ready with another 2-2. Swing and a liner. He's under it, and that ends the inning. But the damage from the D-backs happened here on this grand slam. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's the Diamondbacks 5 and the Dodgers 1. So now into the box is Cody Bellinger, and he blasted a homer in his first at bat.
Yeah, not fooled by that breaking ball in his last AB at all. He jumped all over it. That's such a good feeling as a hitter when you know.
And he jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. A leap, but he can't bring it back into the park. It's a home run. Solo shot to right center. His second of the game, and it's now a 5-2 game.
Man, you could see the center fielder tracking the ball the entire way. He thought he had it, and he might tell you he should have had it, but he just couldn't bring it back into the yard. Sometimes it's a game of inches, folks.
Standing in now, Will Smith. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Bases are empty here. Nobody out. Hanging curveball taken, though, for a second strike.
Ooh, I'm shocked he got away with that one, boys. Curveball right down the middle of the plate. And for him to take that pitch looking, he had to be sitting on something else, but he should have pulled the trigger.
Still 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. High in the air out to center field. Smith is there, and he makes the catch for the out. And that will bring up the versatile Max Muncy. One run in and one gone so far in this inning. Two runs on two hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Way outside, nearly to the backstop. 2-1. Two and two. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Long run for the center fielder, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out.
The second baseman.
Now it'll be Chris Taylor, 0-1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through. The 2-1 home.
Hey, I got to commend him a little bit. Lead off homer, and now he's one pitch away from getting out of this inning without any further damage.
Pulled the string on him. Strike three swinging. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Dodgers claw back a bit on the solo home run. We played four. It's now 5-2. striding in is Asdrubal Cabrera, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. Now a swing and a fly ball. On the move is Betts, and foul. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Eduardo Escobar, a hit and two tries for him so far. Bases are empty, one man out. Sharp ground ball to third. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Now batting left fielder, David Peralta.
To the plate now, David Peralta. And the count will be full. The 3-2 now from Price. Now a curveball that's yanked high and deep down the line in right. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. David Peralta with a two-run shot. And the lead is now 7-2. And as we take another look at that one on ShowTrack, the story behind that home run was speed and the speed with which it was launched off the bat. Didn't have a ton of height on it, but 113 miles an hour, an impressive exit velocity. At the plate now, Christian Walker. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Seven runs, just six hits. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. Hit hard towards center. That's his first base hit, making 1-for-2 now.
Up next to the Diamondbacks, the catcher, Dalton Varsho.
Into the box, Dalton Varsho. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. Throw won't be in time as he reaches it first. At the plate, Nick Ahmed. And there's a base hit on the line. And the second run will score. It's now 9-2.
They say when it rains, it pours, and it's pouring out there right now. Drives in two more with that shot, making it four runs in the inning. This inning is starting to get away from him.
Garrett Clevenger, a 6'1" southpaw, will be the one that gets the call from the bullpen here. Into the box now, Merrill Kelly. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher, but sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Ball three. 3-1 now as that misses down and in. Josh Rojas is on deck. Runner at second here with one man out. Fouled off. Ready now with the payoff pitch.
A bouncer up the middle. And that is through into center field, a base hit. The throw to the plate, and not in time as the run scores.
Well, that run won't be charged against him, but he's still disappointed. His job is to shut the door down when they call on him, and he just couldn't get it done there.
And now, Josh Rojas. Oh, and he had a hanger, but he missed it. It's 1-2. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire. Ball two. 2-2, here it is. Hit down the third baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. From the stretch. Swing and a miss on the breaking pitch, two away.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
Smith.
Standing in now, Haven Smith, hit in the air down the right field line. Betts on the run. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Nine men come to the plate, however, five of them score. Home half of the fifth coming up. Diamondbacks lead this one 10-2. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
All right, thanks, Heidi. So now to the plate. Gavin Lux comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame.
If you look at their win percentage or something like that right now, gotta be honest, the odds are obviously stacked against them. But I'm looking for them to show me something right here. Maybe they get back in this game, maybe they don't. But I want to see what kind of at-bats they put together. This is where you have to lock in as a team. Every guy has to go up to the plate and have a good, productive AB to get this team going.
Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone, count full now. A.J. Pollock waits on deck. Popped him up. Escobar over to his left, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Next, it'll be A.J. Pollock. He's 0-for-1 thus far. One out, nobody on. Pollock in front, three balls and a strike.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust your fundamentals and stay on that fastball.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Too high, and that cost him ball four.
The pitcher, number 61. Garrett.
So here's the Dodgers pitcher, Garrett Clevinger. First at bat of the game for him here in the fifth, as he was a late entrant into this one. High ties him up with a fastball inside, 1-2. Action now in the Arizona bullpen as they have a right-hander up and throwing. Runners on first with one down. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
I always like watching pitchers that attack with their fastballs until there's a reason to start now mixing it up. He hasn't needed many of his secondary pitches so far on this one, and there was another good fastball for a strikeout there.
So now to the plate, Mookie Betts, fouled away. The 1-2. And this one's in the dirt. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch.
Well, the intent there with that two-strike pitch was obviously to get him to fish for something he couldn't do a whole lot with, but there's the risk that comes with that as well. If you don't execute or your catcher can't handle it very well, you give up free bases.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Popped him up. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to put this one away. Good reactions there, and the inning is over. Dodgers leave one, and the lead stays at 8. It's 10-2. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll give way to the third baseman as Drubal Cabrera. Now the 1-1 pitch.
I got 2-1 to count.
And he misses again, ball three. Eduardo Escobar is on deck. One pitch is a slider, and he can't pull the trigger. It's 3-2 now. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Bellinger's under it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. So here's Eduardo Escobar, 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. Bases are empty, one man out. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Curveball misses here, so a good hitter's count now to 3-1.
And when you're already down by a bunch, this is where a guy's got to take some responsibility out there and at least start throwing some strikes.
Three balls and two strikes to Eduardo Escobar. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The 3-2 one more time. Shoots this one over to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So next to hit is David Peralta. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a liner. And that's in there. So perhaps some life here with two men out.
Hey, they weren't going to keep this guy down for long. That's the ebbs and flows of a baseball season. Bottom line is this guy has bat-to-ball skills. You knew he was going to get hot eventually.
Into the box, Christian Walker sent on the ground out to second, and that's through for a hit. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
I don't know what side of the fence I fall on, boys. Old school, new school. I think I kind of stand right along that fence. But one thing that gets me jacked up is watching guys grind down in the count and drive base hits the other way.
To the plate now, Dalton Varsho, swinging a ball hit on the ground. Trying to hang a zero, here's the pitch. Two men are on with two men out.
Take me down, Arizona.
just hung in there on that one.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
A two ball, two strike count to the Diamondbacks catcher.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get to Chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him. So we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
He really needs to find a pitch to put this guy away with right here, right now. He can't allow this inning to get any worse than it's already become.
And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Diamondbacks strand a pair, and the lead stays at 8. It's 10-2. Matt Peacock enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the 6th. Bottom of the inning now, and standing in is the veteran third baseman, Justin Turner. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd, foul. Down the third baseline, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Another one sent foul. Here now the 2-2. Line drive to center field. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
Dan, he took that right back at his face right there. Exactly what you're trying to do. Middle cut, though. Are you a little concerned?
Yeah, that's a case of a ball being right down the middle. As a pitcher, you want to work the corners and stay out of that middle part of the zone, and he paid for it right there with a solid base hit.
Cody Bellinger stands in looking for home run number 3 right here as you see what he's done so far in this one. Nobody out, runner on first. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike 3 called, one away.
Flat out locked him up with the changeup right there. Usually you're trying for a swing and miss when you throw that pitch in a two strike count, but clearly he wasn't looking for it, so it's a backwards K for him.
Stepping in now, Will Smith. Changeup just off the black, and it's 2-1.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
The 2-1 is swung on and missed for strike number 2. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. Runner at first here, one man out. Hit in the air out to right. Rojas is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So now two gone now for the Dodgers in the 6th, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitter Max Muncy. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch down the left field line and hard hit. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
The good news for pitchers in this park is that it doesn't give up many home runs. A lot of room in the outfield. Sometimes that's the bad news as well, though, because there's a lot of space for hits to get down and to go for extra bases just like that.
Into the box now, Chris Taylor, lifted in the air to center field. No trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Dodgers strand a couple, and the lead stays at 8. It's 10-2. And stepping in, Nick Ahmed. Already a home run and a double for him in this one. The 2-2.
It's been a great job so far by the eight-hole hitter. If he finds a way to get on base, this could spell for a huge inning.
Now the payoff pitch home. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Pollock has a read on it. One away. Coming to the plate now, the pitcher for the Diamondbacks, Matt Peacock. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number 7. Fastball well outside. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. The 2-1. Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Giving chase is Bellinger. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And that will hop over the wall now as he'll be awarded second base here. It's a ground rule double. Phil Bickford enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is. In now, Josh Rojas. Pitch popped up. And there's the second out as he squeezes it while standing on the mound.
The bat.
That brings up Haven Smith. Haven. Runner in scoring position with two gone. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Has a look, now the pitch. And it's fouled away. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball 3.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Now the payoff pitch home. Liner toward right center. And Mookie will make the play, and that retired the side. One left for Arizona, and the lead stays at 8. It's 10-2. Last half of the 7th here, and coming forward now is the shortstop, Gavin Lux. The 3-2 pitch. Line to the right side, but this is going to land foul, so they'll tee it up again. 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. High in the air out to center field. Smith is right there, one down. One gone now in the LA seventh, and that'll bring up A.J. Pollock.
Pollock.
The 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike 3.
Well, you got to love a live young arm. He's got an electric fastball, and if he can learn to harness that and work in his solid secondary stuff, he's going to have a really nice career on the mound. Not everyone is gifted with a fastball like that.
Matt Beatty will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Two out, nobody on. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball. 2-2.
That swing had one purpose, and that was to put the ball over the wall. I guess he doesn't have much to lose with his team down this many at this point in the game.
Fastball hit on the ground is short. There is Ahmed. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. This one pretty well in the bag. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. It's the Diamondbacks 10 and the Dodgers 2. Joe Kelly comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. Now to bat, Asdrubal Cabrera looking to change his fortunes here. 0 for 4 with 2 strikeouts so far in the game. The 1-1 home.
Ball, that's out.
As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan Dero, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage of it.
You know, Dero, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
And he fouls this one off.
Hey, 3 foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put away stuff.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His 3rd punch out of the game.
That's the 3rd time in this game he's gone down on strikes. Not the game he was hoping to have when he was taking batting practice, but at least his guys are ahead.
At the plate, Eduardo Escobar, and that's outside. He lost him ball 4.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Into the box, David Peralta. Looked like the sinker there, dipped a little below the knees.
Hey, expect a challenge right here. Does not want to run the count full.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Hit hard up the middle. Oh, look at Taylor. One there. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. Nothing doing here this half. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the 8th coming up. D-backs out in front, 10-2. So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. He's hitless in his 2 at-bats so far. Here's the 2-1 home. Fouled off. He did well to get a piece that time, and it'll stay 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2. Lifted in the air out to left. After it is Peralta. And he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out. Next to dig in, Justin Turner. He's got a hit in 3 at bats to this point. The 2-1 home. Waves and misses for strike number 2. And he missed with it here, so now it's a full count, 3-2. One out, nobody on. Liner towards second, but right to the second baseman, and that's the second out.
the center fielder, number 35, Cody.
Next up, Cody Bellinger. Two home runs already to his name in this one, and we'll see if he could possibly strike again. The 1-1 home. And it wouldn't be a game in Southern California without the obligatory beach ball sighting as this one makes its way onto the field. Bases are empty here with two men out. Pulled toward right center field. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Dodgers down in order. And the lead stays at eight. It's 10-2. Set to start the ninth in this one, and here comes the first baseman, Christian Walker. Now he turns and smokes this one into deep center field, and he will run this one down, moving to his right, and that's the first out of the inning.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
Next up is Dalton Varsho, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
And that one right down Main Street. Softly hit toward the hole. Taylor with a bare hand. Just late. He's safe. Nearly a highlight reel play, but they'll have a runner on here with one away.
You know, D-Row, as a pitcher, that can be so frustrating. You're taught to try to go out there and make quality pitches, and that was a really good pitch, and I would be willing to bet you he's surprised that that turned into an infield single.
Yeah, at the end of the day, he's smiling. That hitter's smiling, running down first base, knowing he's got an infield single right there. He has no business. He'll line out probably 15 times, but it won't even out. You take him when you can get him.
At the plate now, Nick Ahmed. And this is lined hard to deep left. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one out double.
Man, that's a nice job by the batter right there, keeping the front side in. Not easy on a curveball. Would have been easy to throw to front side and hook that foul, but he was able to stay inside and drive it for a base hit.
To the plate now, Matt Peacock. This is on the ground over to first. Oh, beautiful dive. He is out.
Oh, that's a tough play, but he pulled it off perfectly. Once he made the great stop, still had to make a good feed to the pitcher covering, which isn't easy on routine grounders sometimes. Hard not to appreciate that one.
Stepping in now, Josh Rojas. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. Haven Smith would be next. Two outs here with a runner at third. And he missed with it there, ball four. It's a two-out walk with the runner still at third.
Now batting. The center fielder,
Jimmy Nelson, enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is. Haven Smith will be the first one to greet him now as he'll do so with runners at the corners and two out in the inning. Bounce to first. Scooped up. Muncy will win the race to first easily, and that ends the inning. A run on a couple of hits here for Arizona. On to the bottom of inning number nine. 4, 5, and 6 coming up. Arizona's on top, 11-2. Here now is Will Smith starting things for his side in the ninth as they face the improbable odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point, but these guys know these bats still count, at least for their own stats. You can't mill in your chances as a professional.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
No, that's down.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. And could this be the start? It's a long way back, but the leadoff man is on base to start their final set of at-bats.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count, and the ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind an account like that, though.
Strike two taken, a fastball that clips the inside black.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Here he comes again, 1-2. Skied into straightaway right. Rojas settles under it, and there's one away. Now to the plate, Chris Taylor. He flew out in his last debut. The 1-1 is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
The problem for the batter now is he's gotten so inside conscious after those first two pitches, anything on the outer half of the plate's going to look a foot outside.
Misses, ball two.
This guy uses that two-seamer to set up his other pitches. Two-seamer in, breaking ball away.
Here now the 2-2. Hit on the ground to third. Cabrera gets to it. On to first, and he rolls a double play ball to end it here as this ball game is over.
And this will wind up being one of those kind of saves you used to see back in the 70s. I'll tell you, he was on fumes at the end there, but he found a way to get it done.
11-2 is the way this ball game ends. The Arizona Diamondbacks took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Merrill Kelly gets the W on the mound. Tony Gonsolin couldn't escape the fourth inning as he slapped with the loss. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game this afternoon: for the victorious Diamondbacks, 11 runs, 15 hits, no errors. They left 10 men on.